So, Minister, have you any good news for the 600,000 people who have disabilities in this country who want to see this ratified?
That I've just come from a Cabinet meeting, and the Cabinet has agreed to formally ratify the UN Convention on the Rights of People with Disabilities. Today's government decision is a significant milestone. I am delighted, Cian Chóla, that my colleagues in government have supported me in deciding that the Convention should be ratified by Ireland. We will be returning to this at the next government meeting with the formal process in train. And I am confident, Cian Chóla, that all of the necessary administrative processes will be completed within a matter of a few weeks. My focus, as you all know, has been to promote, protect and enjoy human rights for all of our citizens, and in this case, on the UN Convention for all people with a disability. I also want to welcome the progress made in recent weeks and months on the drafting of legislation by the Department of Health on the deprivation of liberty. It is a positive development and testament to the fact that genuine progress on meeting the needs and rights of people with disabilities is being made. Deprivation of liberty is a very sensitive and important matter, which goes to the heart of fundamental freedoms and human rights. Legislative proposals in this area will have significant implications for families, the operation of the health services and the courts. It is important that people fully understand what is being proposed. In this regard, I will be inviting submissions from the stakeholders and from the general public. We are making good progress in making all of the Convention's requirements operational in Ireland in an appropriate manner. Considerable progress has been made to overcome the remaining legislative barriers to Ireland's full implementation of the Convention as set out in the roadmap in the 2015 roadmap. The Assisted Decision-Making Capacity Act 2015 was signed into law on the 30th December 2015, and it is a comprehensive reform of the law on decision-making capacity. Section 5 of the Criminal Law Sexual Offences Act 1993 was reformed through a 2017 Act of the same name to facilitate the full participation in family life of persons with intellectual disabilities and the full expression of their human rights. There are two further priority implementation issues. These are the enactment of the Disability Bill 2016 and the commencement of the Assisted Decision Capacity Act 2015, which requires the Decision Support Service to be operational and ready to roll out the new decision-making support options. The budget, the 2018 budget, has provided an allocation of $3 million for the establishment of the Decision Support Service. And I'm also delighted to announce that we've appointed the Director of the Decision Support Service in October. In the meantime, I'm continuing to take a wide range of practical measures to improve the lives of people with disabilities. The report of the Make Work Pay Group was published in April of this year, and already action has been announced by Minister Harris has taken on its recommendations. We have a comprehensive employment strategy in place, and 2017 has seen positive measures being taken to support public sector recruitment of people with disabilities. I published the Disability Inclusion Strategy in July of this year, containing a wide range of practical commitments to improve the lives of people with disabilities. And there were over 114 recommendations, and already many of these are being implemented. So, Cian Chóla, I promise we would ratify the UNCRPD, and I'm delivering on that promise tonight with support from this government.
Thank you, Minister. Deputy Kenny.